That Russian diplomat is now gone. The squatter that was on that plot of land, the High Court saying that he had no right to be there. The Ukrainian ambassador, Vasil Moroshnichenko, repeated today, just a little while ago, that he'd like to see a Ukrainian embassy built here, that there'd be a plot of land for Ukraine. Would that suit? Would that be one that's appropriate for Ukraine?
I think the government's right to take heed of the security advice in relation to sensitivities on that land and to tread cautiously in relation to that land. And let's be very clear, the Australian Parliament has made its will clear that Russia's not welcome on that land. Now the High Court has been clear in upholding the law that Russia has no place on that land, and it's important from here on in that the government does everything within its power to ensure that Russia doesn't make fools of anybody and use any other means to put people or any further assets on that land, and that it is fully reclaimed for Australian purposes. But completely separately, the government should be prioritising finding an appropriate site for Ukraine to be able to establish a permanent embassy and presence in Australia. Clearly, this conflict has brought our two countries closer together. There are other factors in the past, particularly our work in response to the downing of MH17, that brought our countries closer together. And the importance now of us working with fellow democracies, especially European democracies, means that we should give that support and priority to Ukraine having that permanent home in Australia, as well as, critically, giving support to reopening Australia's embassy in Kyiv and having an ambassador resident in Ukraine.
Simon Birmingham, thanks as always. Talk to you soon.
Thanks, Kieran. My pleasure.